The wait action allows you to wait a period of time before continuing to the next rule. Let's demonstrate this. I have these two rules here that autofill the first name and the last name. If you want to add a 4 second wait time between the first name and the last name, then do this. Enter the second number, the delay in seconds, and then drag this rule in between the two previous rules. Now, you should see a 4 second delay between the first name and the last name being autofilled. Like that. You can also wait for an element to show up on the page before continuing to the next rule. And I'll show you how to do that. I want to create autofill rules for these two fields, password and confirm. Let's test out our new rules. Make sure they work. Let's remove this wait rule because it's causing everything else to wait. Okay, now let's say you want to wait until this element is added to the page before autofilling the confirm field. Here's how you would do that. Wait. Enter the CSS selector for this field that you're waiting on. If this name column is entered, then the value column becomes a timeout value, not a delay in seconds, but a timeout. The default timeout is 1 second. So for the purpose of this demo, I'm going to increase it to 30 seconds. And then move the rule, drag it in between the two password fields. So this will get autofilled after the 30 second timeout or until this field is added to the page, like so. And that's it. The wait action has a lot of uses, and I will let you guys explore all of its uses. Until next time.